Hello, PTA family. Are you ready to celebrate the 2020-2021 National PTA Reflections winners? We are so excited to showcase our student artists. Shout out your state in the comment box. For over 50 years, the National PTA Reflections Program has provided millions of students with access to the arts, which boosts their overall confidence and success. The Reflections Program was founded on PTA's belief that by creating original works of art in response to a student-selected theme, children explore their own thoughts, feelings, and ideas, develop artistic literacy, increase confidence, and find a love for learning that will help them become more successful in school and in life. Each year, over 300,000 students in pre-K through grade 12 create original works of art in response to a student-created theme in the following arts categories: dance choreography, film production, literature, music composition, photography, and visual arts. The program also offers a special artist division to recognize students with disabilities who participate. As a tiered arts recognition program, winning student artworks advance from the local PTA level up through district, region, council, and state PTA competitions to the national level. In the face of a global pandemic, and alongside widespread discussions around the importance of racial equity, National PTA received nearly 900 student artworks from 44 states, responding to the student-created theme, I Matter Because. On May 1st, over 200 students from across the country were announced as National PTA Reflections winners. Seven of these extremely talented artists were additionally honored with the Outstanding Interpretation Award, our highest achievement in the PTA Reflections program. Today, we are excited to celebrate all of our national winners and highlight the work of our seven 2020-2021 Reflections Outstanding Interpretation Awardees. Are you ready to meet our creative student artists? Let's get started. Our first National Reflections Outstanding Interpretation Award is for the photography category. This year's winner is Marin Elizabeth Jacob from Florida. Let's hear from Marin about her photograph titled Youthful Guardian.
Hello, my name is Marin Elizabeth Jacob from Lawton Childs Middle School PTA. I won the Outstanding Interpretation Award for photography. I would like to share with you my artist statement. I matter because I fight for my beliefs. Though I am young, I believe I still have an impact on the world. This world is suffering, and we need to do everything we can to help undo the things we have done. As a part of the upcoming generation who will need to fix our world so that the next generations after us still have a place to live. I am very proud that I won this award, and I am very thankful.
What an inspiring message. Now let's learn more about the inspiration for Marin's artwork.
I like doing photography because I can share the experiences with other people, and I can show them how I see the world. Thank you for allowing me to show my piece today. Next up, Outstanding Interpretation Award winner for dance choreography.
Thanks, Marin. Our Outstanding Interpretation Award for the dance choreography category is Sydney Ware from Georgia. Let's hear from Sydney about her piece and watch her dance performance titled In This Shirt.
Hi, I'm Sydney Ware from the DeKalb School of the Arts PTA in Georgia. And I won the award for Outstanding Interpretation and Dance Choreography for my piece, In This Shirt. And I'm going to read my artist statement to you. The song, In This Shirt, is about being lost as an individual, so I use that as a way to represent that we are all lost sometimes. The video begins with the dancers describing why they matter. The dance begins with them wearing shirts that say, Why Do I Matter? Throughout the dance, they find themselves as individuals and have their own solo moments. They also change into their own individual outfits to express finding their own individuality. On the journey to finding yourself, there will always be reasons why you matter. I really enjoyed working on this piece. At the time, we've been in quarantine for around 6 months, so I was just really ready to put positive energy into something that I enjoy doing. And I heard the song In the Shirt a few years ago at a dance competition, and I had not heard the song again until 2020. So I was immediately inspired to choreograph a new piece to it, and I submitted that piece into Reflections. The dancers in this video are super talented and they really helped bring my vision to life. So all in all, it was just a really awesome experience, and choreographing this piece was exactly what I needed after the rough year we had. And I'm so happy that so many people got to enjoy the piece as well.
So why do you matter?
I matter because I'm here to help people.
I matter because I bring light.
I matter because I'm the beginning of a new generation, a generation that's gonna bring new beginnings.
I matter because I play a unique role in the grand scheme of things.
I matter because I have a chance to change history to then create a new future.
I am lost.
impressive dancers truly embody this year's theme. Let's learn more about Sydney's creative process from the artist herself.
I love to dance, and I've been dancing since I was little. And I think that dancing is a way to express yourself and express your emotions without having to verbalize them. And you're telling a story through your movements, and I've always really loved that about dance. And personally, choreographing is just a way for me to express myself and put like pieces of myself out there. And I also really enjoy seeing how dancers kind of interpret movement and just take what you give them and make it their own. In reflections, I think that it's an amazing opportunity for the youth to express themselves through the arts and just cover serious topics while we do so. So we get to talk about things that are important to us, but we also get to show how unique and creative we are. Thank you all for the love and support I received throughout this entire process, and thank you for allowing me to share my piece with you. Next, you will hear from the Outstanding Interpretation winner in Literature.
Thank you, Sydney. Next up, we have our Outstanding Interpretation Award for our Literature category. This year's winner is Joshua Johnson from Utah. Let's hear from Joshua about his writing process and hear him do a reading of his piece titled The Voice in My Head.
Hello, my name is Joshua Johnson, and I am from the Benyon Junior High PTSA here in Taylorsville, Utah. I won the Outstanding Interpretation Award in the Literature category for my poem titled The Voice in My Head. And I kind of want to share my artist statement with you guys today. 2020 has been unbelievably challenging for so many people, including me, with the physical, emotional, financial, academic, political, and social challenges that we have all faced this year. I wanted to write a poem that expressed the feelings that I have had and the feelings that I have heard about. I believe I matter because I can do hard things. I am becoming a better person, a better student, a better family member, and a better member of our society because of the things I am learning by being resilient. Because I know that I matter, I believe I can help other people know they matter. I am so honored and humbled to have won this award, and I am grateful that I get to share it today at National PTA's virtual convention. The voice in my head. My ears perk with pensiveness as my parents wrangle about pandemics. My eyes ache from superfluous screen time spent salvaging my academics. This perpetuator of panic shut down my school, my church, and my teams. It shrank my social circles and attacked my sleep with unsettled dreams. Being social feels so distant as we zoom around to connect, while we mask our smileless faces and our true feelings reject. The voices around me shout, "It doesn't matter. Give up. You're alone." But the voice in my head softly replies, "Keep going. Keep working. Persistence is brilliant." It whispers, "I matter because I am resilient." Flash forward a fortnight to foundations shaking, picture frames falling and ceiling lights quaking. Panicked parents call my name as I dive under the table. 5.7 on the Richter scale. My nerves are rattled, my logic disabled. My legs are an unsteady sailor stepping off from the sea. My knees tremble with rippling aftershocks, and I wonder when my limbs will be free. The voices around me yell in my ear, "Be anxious, be alarmed, be filled with fear." But the voice in my head firmly declares, "Get up, get moving. Get out from down there." It whispers, I matter, because I am courageous. My tear ducts are burning, my nostrils assailed, smoky tendrils slither where dirt trenches have failed. Across the mountainous skyline, orange dangers appear, leaping and hurling, consuming all that is near. Ashy remnants of California and Colorado waft a warning, hissing, beware, while merging with the molecules of our own fiery despair. The voices around me holler, why should you care? It isn't your home that floats in the air. But the voice in my head is quick to respond. Empathy and concern are how I reach higher. It whispers, I matter because my choices inspire. Injustices exposed and dark narratives now spoken, shining light on an imperfect union where liberty is broken. Cities rally together, proclaiming enough is enough. Peaceful protests permutate into ravenous riots. So rough. While messages are spray painted and buildings are burned, police tear gas is deployed and police cars overturned. The voices around me scream, be divided, be vicious, be cruel. But the voice in my head rapidly refutes. Be united. Show kindness in all that you do. It whispers, I matter because I respect you. Jobs dissolve like sidewalk chalk in a summertime rainstorm, creating blurry pictures of the future that lies ahead. A deluge of bills and drought of paychecks cause parents to worry about keeping kids fed. Stock prices decline, releasing a downpour of empty grocery shelves and pantry cupboards. My palms go clammy, and my heart aches from the things I have discovered. Retirements, savings, and homes evaporate away, while people pile up in unemployment lines. Street corners are claimed by calloused hands holding faded cardboard signs. The voices around me spout, why bother? Why try? It's pointless anyway. But the voice in my head boldly rebukes, I cannot, I will not, I won't quit today. It whispers, I matter because I have hope. Through sadness and sickness, disease and dying, through anguish and anger, chaos and crying, I focus on forward. I positively push on. I know better days are coming. All these things will be gone. The stronger the wind, the more resilient the tree. This is the person that I choose to be. I know this because of the voice in my head.
Thanks, Joshua, for sharing your work with us. Now let's hear from the writer himself to understand the inspiration for his poem.
I love reading. I love those words on paper. I really enjoy how they sound, what they mean, the images that they can build. I love the emotions that they can convey and the connections that they can build between you and a world you had no previous experience of. I usually write poems to express what's in my head and what's in my heart. Last year's poem was just all about what's in my heart. There wasn't really much mental influence on that. I was really nervous to share it because it was really personal to me. It was my attempt to articulate everything I'd been feeling about that year, just cram it into a bunch of those stanzas. To be honest, I kind of didn't want to share it. Just wanted to hang that up in my bedroom and read it whenever I was feeling sad. But so many people have told me that it conveys exactly what they were feeling through the entire pandemic. It took me about a week to come up with the draft and actually fit some of that emotion in there, then another 3 weeks to polish it and refine it and try to cram more emotion into those lines. I like to talk through the lines on my own to try and hear the alliterations, see how the words can connect to each other in a way that they couldn't do alone. When I finally finished it, even though I didn't give a copy to my mom or my dad till a couple of weeks after, I read it to my mom and she just started tearing up. And then I knew it was an okay poem. But I had no clue how many other people would really enjoy reading that as well. Next, you guys are gonna hear from the outstanding interpretation winner in the music composition category. And they're awesome. Goodbye.
Joshua is right. It's now time for our Outstanding Interpretation Award for our Music Composition category. This year's winner is Johann Novak from Washington. Let's learn a bit about Johann's work and listen to his original composition, Legacy.
Hi, I'm Johann Novak. I attend Odell Middle School in the Bellevue School District in Washington State. I feel honored to receive the Outstanding Interpretation Award in the Music Composition category for my song, Legacy. This past year has been difficult for all of us, as well as our country and our world. Many of us have lost people we loved and have had to face not knowing what tomorrow brings. Writing my reflection song helped me express my feelings, and I hope that my music has personal meaning to you. I would now like to share my artist statement with you. Last summer, our dear family friend with cancer spent her final days in hospice care in our home. She was a phenomenal musician, my music teacher, and most of all, my friend. She left me her legacy of music and love and inspired me to write this song. In her death, I saw how precious life is. We take so many things for granted and forget that tomorrow is not guaranteed. I matter because I create a legacy with each day that I have. I can make the world a better place and honor those who gave me so much. I feel so honored to receive this award and have this opportunity to share my song with you today at the National PTA's virtual convention. I hope you enjoy my music composition, Legacy.
Would it matter if no eagle could ever fly? in space, and the astronauts on board could not touch base. Yes, it matters to me to embrace what may not always be. I know tomorrow's not guaranteed as I leave my legacy. My life will honor the memory of those who mattered just like me.
What a powerful performance. Let's hear more from Johan about the creative inspiration for his music.
I have loved music from a very early age. My mom says that I even loved singing as a baby. When I was little, my grandma and great-grandma used to sing and play instruments with me.
You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray.
In kindergarten, I joined the Northwest Boy Choir. The same year, I also started taking music lessons. I now play piano, ukulele, guitar, drums, violin, and the harmonica. I've been writing songs since kindergarten. Some were not so good, but my mom always saved them and loved them. I wrote several songs for reflections over the years, and even though I didn't win, the PTA made me feel like my artwork was important and appreciated. Thank you for encouraging me to share it, or I wouldn't be here today. It takes bravery for kids like me to share their artwork. Sharing your artwork publicly is difficult because it exposes you to criticism. Thank you to all the PTA volunteers all over the country who have celebrated all of the participants with school art shows, celebration videos, school news, broadcasts, and more. I would also like to thank all of the volunteer judges for their time and commitment. The Reflections program was founded in 1969. It's even older than my mom, but don't care if I said that. The Reflections program has encouraged students to explore the arts for over 50 years. Thank you. It's important to have this platform for all of us to share our feelings through art. As my artist statement explained, I lost my dear friend Patty last spring. She always encouraged me to write music, so I wanted to write something really special. She was at her home during her final days of hospice, and I played music and sang to her. It was a very special time, but also very difficult. After she died, I thought about this year's theme, I Matter Because. I thought about Patty and how much she mattered to me. I also thought about all the underappreciated things in life, like nature. We assume that the people we love and that the nature we cherish will always be there. I then thought about the legacy we all leave on this earth. First, I started with a melody. The phrase, "Would it matter?" fit the melody and the theme perfectly. I then built the song around that phrase. It took me the whole summer because I had so many variations of the song and the melody. It also took me all summer because this is what my life is when I play piano or try to record. Some versions of my song were not so good, but I kept working on the melody until I had something that I really liked. I added instruments, harmony, and background singing to complete it. I kept revising until it came together perfectly. I hope my song reminds others to reflect on the important contributions each of us brings to this world. Thank you for allowing me this amazing opportunity to share a little about myself and my song. Next, you will hear from the Outstanding Interpretation winner in film production. Goodbye.
Thanks, Johan. You're right. It's now time for our Outstanding Interpretation Award for the Film Production category. This year's winner is Zoe Caraballo from New Jersey. Let's hear from Zoe about her work and then watch her film, I Matter.
Hi, my name is Zoe Caraballo and I'm from New Jersey representing the Green Hills PTA. I feel incredibly honored to have won the Outstanding Interpretation Award for the artwork I Matter in the Film Production category. I've had an affection for poetry long before film production and consider this an opportunity to combine the two. COVID has affected society in a negative way. I wanted my video to showcase that even during these difficult times, or even when it may seem that the odds are against us, we could still make a difference. Everything we do has an impact on the world, and sometimes that impact has a profound, lasting effect.
You log onto a virtual world. Right when you spawn, you find one stone block. You then start walking in one direction, and you find a whole trail of stone. You continue to walk for about 1,610 blocks and notice that you've reached 1 mile. Imagine that you've traveled that distance, but 238,900 more times. Congrats, you've reached the distance from Earth to the Moon. You eat your steak and continue on until you've done this for about 53 million times. You now reach the distance from Earth to Mars. You're really tired, but for some reason you decide to follow the trail even longer. You've now done this for about 248,447,204,969 times and find one singular block of diamonds. Congrats. This one block of diamond compared to every single piece of stone you've passed are the odds of me being born. And you thought the odds of winning the lottery were against you. Life is rigged. But somehow I beat those odds, along with you and everyone else who has ever lived. Well, I've already exceeded the probability of being born. I might as well live a life worth living for and make a difference. I may not be able to do things like solving world hunger or finding a cure for COVID-19. Who knows? But through small acts, I can help change society today. I have a great fascination with science and how living things work. If I continue to learn more and more about this, I can possibly make groundbreaking discoveries that can change the world and maybe even save some people. I matter. When my sister fell off her bike, I helped her get up and try again. Now she could go faster than me. I matter. When I helped my friend study for a test, she started to feel more confident. She passed. I matter. Due to COVID, my grandmother lives in isolation. I make an effort to call her every day and tell her that I love her. I matter. When I lost a basketball game, I said to myself, "Good game," and practice harder. I won the next one. I matter. One small act today could change the world tomorrow. So the next time you have a bad day and feel the odds are against you, either physically or mentally, just remember this. You've already beat such greater odds. You exist and you have a chance to make a difference. And so do I, along with everyone else in the world. I've chosen to matter. You should too.
thank you, Zoe, for sharing with us why you matter. We'll now hear more from Zoe about the creative process for her film production.
I conveyed my message by creating analogies using a well-known video game that a young audience can most especially relate to. My sister and I enjoy Minecraft. I guess you can say we have an obsession, but probably no different than most kids our age. The edit was put together in Adobe Premiere with very little special effects. I think it was my message, the verbal content, that would be more appealing than the special effects. Well, with the exception of an interesting shot I put together where I show what seems like an infinitely long row of blocks flowing far out in the galaxy, what I did there is I built a virtual environment filled with green grass and blocks raised high. Within Premiere, I used an alpha matte, better known as a green screen, to substitute the grass, the green area, with a video of the galaxy. I created scenes by using a level creation language that allowed me to create simple shapes on a large scale. I instructed one person to spectate, acting as a moving camera, and the other to move, much like an actor. I chose an emotional, thought-provoking musical score with a hook that would captivate my audience. This was a lot of fun and helped me refine my technique. I'm still learning and continue to challenge myself. In fact, I put together another version of this video, translated and narrated entirely in Spanish. This was a huge challenge for me.
Continúas caminando 1610 cuadras y notas que has llegado a una milla.
My parents are Dominican and Puerto Rican. My heritage is very important to me, and unfortunately, I don't speak Spanish natively. If you're the kind of person who's interested in the extras at the end of a movie, go and check out my YouTube channel, Poet Like Zoe. How do you think I did? Hopefully not too bad. I feel privileged and honored to be awarded, and now I am pleased to present you with the Outstanding Interpretation winner in Visual Arts.
Yes, next up, we have our Outstanding Interpretation Award for our Visual Arts category. This year's winner is Claire Moon from Virginia. Let's hear from Claire about her inspiration, and then take a closer look at her piece, titled My Pieces of Quilt.
Hello, my name is Claire Moon. I am from Rachel Carson Middle School PTA in Virginia. I won the Outstanding Interpretation Award for my visual arts piece, My Pieces of Quilt, and I'd like to share my artist name with you. The thought pieces someone needs during their journey to potential success. Style of paper, which represents the pieces in the story. In this artwork, I incorporate states of paper, including sides where we face failure, so we give up, crumple, and tear what we initially had in mind. Also the remarkable achievements that we pinned and clubbed to stay flexible and fold it into an impacting lesson. Therefore, matter because, by taping together the achievements and failures, I can string together the hardships I faced to grow my identity into a developing masterpiece. In this artwork, I want to share the idea that your failures and achievements can still develop your growth, and that you should not ignore part of yourself just to prove your worth, because we're all developing masterpieces. Whether we're still adding the final touches, or whether we're still in our planning stage. I'm very grateful for my family and my art teachers for supporting my passion of art, and I'd like to thank the National PTA Reflections for giving me the opportunity to share my artwork at the National PTA Virtual Convention.
What a stunning creation. Let's hear more from Claire about the inspiration for her artwork.
When I was thinking of an idea, I wanted it to revolve around the idea that your success does not equal your worth, because everyone in you dislikes the idea of failing. So look for the positives, which includes growth. So I stared at the empty piece of paper in front of me, which had so much potential. I realized this potential that I speak of applies to people as well, because we can all do so much to achieve different results, whether it's something we want or not. So by making the piece of paper to represent me, a representation of how everyone matters, I created my idea. I create art because art is a fun way to express my thoughts of what's happening around me, as if it's my own little world in each of my drawings. Thanks for allowing me the opportunity to share my piece. Next, you will hear from the Outstanding Interpretation winner in the Special Artist Division. Bye.
Thank you, Claire. Our final Outstanding Interpretation Award is for our Special Artist Division. This year's winner is Mark Wagner from California for his dance choreography piece. Let's hear from Mark about his creative inspiration and watch his dance titled, I Speak With My Dancing.
My name is Mark Wagner. I represent Dana Hills High School in California. I won the Outstanding Interpretation Award in Dance Choreography for my piece, I Speak With My Dancing. The dance, feeling balance in the beautiful city I live in Laguna Niguel, California. I'm very happy for winning. Thank you for choosing me.
Will you hold the line when every one of them is giving up and giving in? Tell me, in this house of mine, nothing ever comes without a consequence or cost. Tell me, will the stars align? Will heaven step in? Will it save us from our sin? Will it? Cause this house of mine stands strong. That's the price you pay. Leave behind your heart and cast away. Just another product of today. Rather be the hunter than the prey. And you're standing on the edge, face up, cause you're a natural. I've been in heart of stone. You gotta be so cold to make it. Somebody, let me see the light within the dark trees shadowing what's happening. Looking through the glass, find the wrong within the past, knowing we are the youth. Caught until it bleeds out of world without the peace, face a bit of the truth. The truth, that's the price you pay.
Thank you, Mark, for sharing your creativity with us. Let's hear more from the artist about the inspiration for his performance.
How much did you practice for your piece?
About 2 months.
2 months?
Yeah.
Like every week for 2 months?
Yes.
Why did you choose Imagine Dragons for your music?
Because they're my favorite band, and also I like the group to their songs.
So, Mark, why did you pick Badlands for your piece?
Because we have a beautiful city. I want to show it all to the world.
So, Mark, who helped you create your piece?
Oh, I'll tell you. It was my brother Justin, also Matthew, Dovika McKella, that is also my sister.
And what did they help you do?
They are helping me. They helped me on my dance video.
Did they do the editing?
Yes.
So, Mark, do you have anything else to add?
Yes. I want to thank you. I want to thank my dance teacher, Mrs. Lee. Also, my mom and dad, thank you for mom and dad always supporting, always have my back.
Congratulations to all of the 2020-2021 National PTA Reflections winners. We invite you to explore all of the I Matter Because artwork through our virtual exhibit at pta.org/reflectionsawards. Please use hashtag PTA Reflections on social media to share your thoughts and help us celebrate their accomplishments. Of course, the Reflections program would not be possible without the tremendous work of so many volunteers. Please join us in saying thank you to the local, district, region, council, and state PTA Reflections chairs, the talented judges who review the artwork, and the volunteers and partners that share and celebrate the artwork. Thank you. Special thanks to our generous sponsor, BAND, for supporting the Reflections program. This communications platform has been instrumental to our Reflections leaders as they coordinate their programs. We would also like to let you know that this year's 2021-2022 Reflections program is off and running. The arts have helped us through many challenges this year and will continue to provide students with healthy and creative outlets. Our student-selected theme for this year is I Will Change the World By. Get involved in the arts by starting your own Reflections program and registering your PTA's participation at pta.org/reflections. Congratulations once again to all the talented winners of our 2020-2021 Reflections program. I Matter Because.